At some point, we're going to have to come to some reckoning in Texas, because without the opportunity to vote, they can continue these Neanderthal ideas.
Thank you again for showing up. We love you. We adore you.
Well, thank you very much. First of all, let me say that being from Texas represents knowing that you are from a state of two real different tales. We're also dealing with a state that is majority rural, and that's who tends to get elected in higher office, and that becomes a state of two cultures, one advanced and one against advancement. And I think that the one that prevails at the wrong time is the one that wants us to go back to slavery. When they got all the help they needed on the farms and didn't have to pay minimum wage. And it's unfortunate because it's getting to the point where they're getting more and more vigorous against the majority, frankly, voting. And that's troubling. And at some point, we're going to have to come to some reckoning in Texas, because without the opportunity to vote, they can continue these Neanderthal ideas and the way they function.
So what is it in Texas that they're trying to do? Because we had Georgia, and Georgia is very restrictive, but you're saying Texas is even more restrictive than Georgia. Can you tell us what is on the plate there?
Well, they're in legislative session, which they go in every 140 days every other year. And so they're in a hurry to move forth. They both have a House and Senate bill. Both of them are attempting to remove opportunities for voting based upon the last election. Now, this isn't new. Usually it's some piece of legislation after each major election. But this time, because we had such a vigorous turnout, it's gotten to be seemingly a priority for them to make sure that we don't continue to have that type of turnout.
So when is the vote on these bills, this House and State Senate bill?
Well, any time now. We're trying to keep up enough noise that maybe we can forestall them or kill them. But they only meet 140 days every other year, so it'll be over around the end of May, the regular sessions will be. And what has even made this skewed type voting more important is how the lines get drawn.
Gerrymandering.
We have more minorities in the state than we've ever had. And we have more minorities voting. And I don't mean just African-Americans. We have immigrants who come from all over the world who now seem to be voting more Democratic. Well, when we came in with computer line drawing, they could tailor make these lines. To give you an example, when I came to Congress in the election of 1992, we had 30 seats in Texas congressionally. And we had 21 Democrats. Today we have 36 seats in Congress and might be getting 2 to 3 more after the census. And we have 12 or 13 Democrats. Now there's no way that makes any sense until you look at how they achieve these lines, these districts. And when you look at the lines, it is becoming more and more difficult to deny the concentration of blue voting to have success. And so the only way they are leading to now to get that success is to eliminate the voters.